Hey there. So it's time to start talking about some of the nuts and bolts about what it's going to be like to be in this class. I want you to consider this video kind of like a user manual for the course. You're going to learn a little bit about how it's organized, what you're going to be responsible for, the different ways that we might explore and learn in this class, and some of how that's going to be reported out to you so that you can get the feedback on your learning to improve over the course of the entire year. So, let's get to it. In the Computer Science and Engineering department, we believe that the best way for you to learn is by designing, building, and making yourself. And so you're going to see us refer to the design cycle quite a bit in this class. We believe that in going through the process of getting an idea, doing some research on that idea, creating something, testing it, and then making a plan for the next version, that you learn a lot about computer science and engineering. You're going to be developing a lot of skills in each stage of the design cycle.
Oh, a QR code. I wonder what that's for.
Anyways, let's talk about the ways we interact with the design cycle in this class in three distinct ways. The first thing that we'll do in this class is have the opportunity to explore. You'll get some design, some program, some tool, and you'll be given the opportunity to explore exactly what it does. You can explore how to take what it does now and get it to do something else. The next thing that we do is known as skill building. You're going to need to learn some skills directly, where we need to teach you how to do something. This could be learning to use a 3D printer, or learning how to use loops effectively in one programming language. The third piece of this class is a design challenge. So you'll see a number of design challenges that enable you to build, make, program, or create something brand new. This could be an app that improves communication during virtual school, or it could be a physical device that makes things easier for a group of people. So whenever you're doing work in this class, you can think about which of these three modes you're actually working in. Okay, before we move on, see if you can find our family hamster Cinnamon in this photo. Let's talk about the gradebook. You know it, I know it. I know it's the first place that you go whenever you turn in an assignment, and it's probably where your parents go as well. So, in the gradebook, you're going to see a lot of the same things that appear in any class that you take here. So you can see a range of categories of assignments and a grade and some places to click around to get more information. I use the flags in PowerSchool pretty often so that I can communicate, have you turned in an assignment? Is the assignment complete or is it missing? So let's say you've turned something in. When the check mark appears, it means that you've submitted it and it meets all requirements for turning it in. Or have you turned in a blank document hoping that I wouldn't take a look at it? I probably will see it, but this also lets you know that I've received it. If after a deadline you have not submitted it, you'll see the orange missing flag, which means I don't have it, and so it's on you to turn that in. And the third thing that you might see there is that it's submitted, but that it's missing something critical. And so what you will want to do is click into the comment in the gradebook to know exactly what it is you're missing. So make sure you take the time to do that anytime you're looking for feedback on an assignment. All assignments in this class are grouped using something called standards. And so standards are sets of skills, knowledge, and understanding that go together. And this makes it really easy for you to understand what you're good at and what you need to work on. You can see all of these standards on the Schoology page for this course. The first standard across all our courses is documenting design decisions. This is the idea that at the end of a project, you can very clearly demonstrate what does whatever you've designed at the end of a project actually do. How does it meet criteria? And how does this product or app fit into the context of the problem you were trying to solve? Standard number two is about iterative design. This is the idea of how a single element of your design has been changed over time. How have you improved it with feedback, learning new skills, and testing your product or app with users? The rest of the standards for the course we're grouping together as computer science skills. And these could be anything from understanding how variables work to your use of feedback in the process of completing a project. Check the course page on Schoology for more information about what all of these standards are. You'll be able to demonstrate mastery over the course of the entire semester. So this is a great opportunity for you to demonstrate a growth mindset and get better and better as you learn and develop your skills. So getting back into the gradebook, you're gonna see a whole bunch of things, a whole bunch of assignments that are organized according to the standards. We've put together a system to help you understand what all of these assignments are, which standard they refer to, and whether the assignment is formative or summative. And you'll be able to find more information on this on the Schoology course information page. You can also look there to find more information about how we handle late work, reassessment, and also intellectual property. The last thing to do is make sure that you are prepared to work. Clear your doc of all applications that you don't need running. Make sure you don't have a bunch of spaces where you might have things running that could get you distracted. And finally, limit the tabs that are running on your computer so that you have just the ones you need for the work that you're about to do. We're really looking forward to a full year working with you in this class. And don't be a stranger, talk to us. If you have questions on anything, please ask. All right, everybody. See you in class real soon.